Now I would like to work through one of the previous exam problems with you. Let's do midterm 2 from 2010, problem 2. The problem is a coaxial cable has a solid center conductor with a radius A and a grounded outer shield with radius B. The inner conductor is carrying a current of 3 R³ in the Z direction plus 2 R² in the phi direction amps per meter squared. The insulating material between the inner conductor and the shield is slightly water-soaked, so it has a small conductivity. It is also conducting a small current from the inner to the outer conductor that is 5 R hat microamps per meter squared. We want to find the magnetic field inside all of the regions of this conductor. So let's begin with part A. Let's find the magnetic field in the region R is less than A. We're going to use Ampere's law to do this because we can see that everything is radially symmetric. So here's Ampere's law. In order to do this contour, here's the contour that we're going to be evaluating. That contour is H phi in the phi hat direction dotted with R d phi in the phi hat direction. Phi goes from 0 to 2 pi. These two are going to dot away to 1, and you're going to end up with R, 2 pi R, H, phi. Now let's find the total current enclosed. The total current enclosed is going to be given by the surface that's inside the contour we just did. So we're going to put our current, 3 R cubed, Z hat, plus 2 R squared, phi hat, and dot that with the surface area that's represented right here. That is going to be R dr d phi in the z hat direction. When I do my dot products, this dot product goes to 1, but this dot product goes to 0. So this part of the current goes away. My radius is going to go from 0 to R, where R is less than A, and phi is going to go from 0 to 2 pi. So when I do this integral, I'm going to get 3 r to the fifth over 5 from 0 to R, and then phi from 0 to 2 pi. That's going to give me 6 pi R to the fifth over 5. When I solve for H phi, I'll have our value for H phi for this problem. Now let's do part B. For part B, I want the radius to be in between A and B. That's this region out here. So I need to be sure that I have picked up all of the current in this shaded region, plus whatever part of the current happens to be in this region right here. Let's first pick up all of the current that's between 0 and A. I do exactly the same thing that I did here, except that I integrate from 0 to A. In addition, I need to be able to pick up this part of the current. So the total current enclosed is going to be 3 R to the fifth over 5 from 0 to A times phi from 0 to 2 pi, plus we need to add in this other part. It's an integral, and it's going to be 5 r hat. I'm going to put the micro in there so remember it's 5 micro. And we're going to dot that with r d phi in the z direction. The integral that I would be doing is from 0 to pi and from r equals a to b, because that's where this current resides. But look what happens when we do this dot product. That goes to 0. So that's not going to get incorporated into our problem at all. So what I have here is that 2 pi r h phi is equal to 3 r to 3 times a to the fifth over 5 times 2 pi. Solve for h phi, and you've got it. Okay, let's go on to the last region. Here was A, here was B, and we want to calculate H phi when R is greater than B. What happens when you ground the outer metal shield here? We have current that showed up in this inner conductor. We have another current that showed up in the region between the two conductors, and those two currents, whatever they happen to be, are going to get summed up on this outer current shield, and it's going to be equal to the sum of I1 plus I2, but we're going to make it negative. This is going to be the ground return current. It's equal to the total currents that are inside, but with a negative sign. So when I add this current, with the other currents that are inside, my total current enclosed is equal to zero. So when we say that 2 pi r h phi is equal to the total current enclosed, which is equal to zero, we can see that h phi is going to be zero outside of our inner conductor.